All right, good morning and welcome back to TwinStick Garage, where the work never stops. So, if you're new to the channel, I just love old trucks and I can't stop working on them, and I really love everything about them. Love the trucking industry, love the people, and most of all, love the trucks. So I've got three active projects going on. That's my Smokey and the Bandit replica. And it's getting pretty close. Got to start working on the trailer with the stagecoach scene and do all of that to finish this project out, and that's gonna happen in the upcoming months as it warms up and I can start working outside again. Over there is my cabover project. It's a 290 inch wheelbase. We're doing it kind of up in the spirit of the one used in the late 70s trucking movie, High Ballin.
Well, what the?
Well, look at that. That's what you call a low bridge.
With Jerry Reed. And this is gonna be quite the custom jobby. So did a lot of work on the frame, welded on this airbag clip. And like I say, it's got about a 290 inch wheelbase. And this truck here, this one is my pride and joy, my 359 Pete. It's kind of where the whole channel started. It's kind of the reason for the name of the channel, of course, because this truck has the two transmissions, or twin sticks, as they're known. And as I mentioned in a few episodes back, I've been planning to get this truck painted and actually finish out the restoration, because there's not much more that this truck needs other than paint. So I guess with that, we'll go ahead and get started. I mean, it's gonna sting to take all this beautiful chrome off of here, but I think we'll come out the other side with something that to be proud of. So with that, I guess let's get at her. Truck's not gonna paint itself. Does that overhead gantry ever come in handy? Okay, so that came off of there easy, and as you can see, this old cat sure likes to smoke. Look at that. All right, so I'll go ahead and swing that over to the other side, drop the other stack, and just looking at it, man, when you take stacks off a truck, it sure changes the look in a hurry, doesn't it? So I've mentioned in earlier videos, previous videos working on this truck, that the right way to build a truck, oh, hit a bolt chunk. The right way to build a truck is to put all the chrome on and then make sure it all fits and then take it all off and paint it. Well, that's not right. The right way to build a truck is to take everything off, sand it all down, do the body work, paint it, and then put the chrome on. That way you only do it once. That's how I did Snowman, so I kind of had it a little bit backwards on this truck, and now I'm paying the price, but no big deal. This stuff comes off a lot easier than it goes on, so it shouldn't take too long to get all this stuff unbolted. Okay, a couple of tips. If you're taking apart your truck for restoration, or you're taking it apart to finish painting it, get yourself a lot of these little plastic bins and then organize for what you're doing. So I had a bin there for all the bolts and brackets. I also need to take those off for the exhaust. And now I'm gonna do the intake, same idea. Now, someone was asking me in the comments, am I gonna paint the bands the same color? So as I mentioned in the video, I'm gonna paint this whole truck if I can get this paint, this sovereign blue, metallic blue Packard color. But I think it's a Emron paint. And some folks were saying that it ain't cheap. It's gonna be like a couple grand just for the paint. But supposedly it's really tough and it lasts a long time, so we'll see. But someone was asking, are you gonna paint the bands? And yeah, I think so. Because why not? It would match better and offset rather than just having them black. So I'll probably hang those and paint those. Same with these brackets here. Oh man, I gotta pop all these lights off. I took the stainless off. Paint your truck and then build it, folks. Can't say that enough. Off, it's just been a bear because you can't get in behind the nuts, and that's probably why the previous owners left it in place, because there's like three coats of paint on each of these nuts here, these bolts. So I don't think this thing's been off since it left the factory. Oh man, you can't get in behind there. It's just terrible. Who would have thought something so small would be so difficult? Get off of here. There it goes. Not looking forward to putting that back on. There. Now, do the same thing all over again on the other side. Finally, got this one off. It was a bear just like the other side. And then I noticed this guy here, and I'm not sure what this is. It looks like it held, there's a ring here that you would tighten up. Now, I've seen these used for antennas. And as you tighten it, it basically pulls the rod in and holds it solid. But, well, I was thinking, well, there should be two of these, but maybe that's what was up here originally. Maybe there was an antenna that went through here, but that would have looked kind of funny. But either way, that was some of the work. That was some of my body work. Back in the day, I just put a smear of fiberglass on there. So I'll try and take this guy off of here. There we go, fixed. And then I wonder, maybe next time Blake's got his welder over, I believe this is all aluminum, we'll just weld that hole closed. That's probably the better way to do it, as opposed to what I did here. Okay, so what's next? I guess take the mirrors off, the antennas, and just keep working my way up. Fun. Okay, so what I was grinding there, one of the previous owners, I guess, used a rivet because the threads must have got tore out of here. Because there is threads in here, which makes it quite easy to take the mirror assembly off. But they used a rivet, so they must have got stripped out. So there was a pop rivet used there, and then this bolt broke off. So what I'll have to do is take off the inner door panel eventually when I want to put this back on there. And I'll have to sort that out. But for now, I'm not gonna worry too much about it. That's the old, what is that? That's the power wire for the heated mirror. They ran it through the door and then up. That's the right way to do it. So when I put this back on and reassemble it, I might actually run the wire. It's a cleaner install to actually go through the tube and then out. See, there's a hole. Obviously it goes through the tube and then there's a hole there where it pops out and then it goes to your lights and your mirror heat. So that's a cleaner way to do it, and I'll definitely do that when I reassemble. Now, a friend of mine was also telling me that the doors, the 359 doors, they're the same dimension as a 379 and a 389. Now that I find hard to believe that they would have kept with that, but perhaps Packard did do that to try and maintain consistency and they didn't have to rejig their door manufacturing whatever line. But, so if a guy wanted to, I could actually go get new doors, but these guys are solid. They just got, you know, four layers of paint on there. So I think I'll just sand them down smooth and reuse them. Now, the one, I believe, so 359 Peterbilt, a lot of guys like, almost like Kenworth better than that, because if you notice on Snowman, they mount solid up here, here and here. So you can actually open the door and your mirror stays looking when you're trying to back up a trailer. You can open the door and look behind and your mirror doesn't move. Whereas on the Peterbilt, when you open the door, your mirror swings out and you lose the ability to see what's going on behind you. So that's one of the drawbacks of the Pete. Now, just looking at the rubber here as well, it's pretty weather beaten. But that can obviously be replaced later on. What I'll probably just do is mask to the edge of it or just underneath. Yeah, this is gonna be a lot of work. But I've never been afraid of a little hard work. Okay, so next up I wanna try and take off the drop visor, but yeah, I'm gonna pay for my let's build a truck before we paint it. So I was at least smart enough to know to not use huck bolts. So these were all huck bolts that I used Ezra's huck gun when I put this new fiberglass roof cap on a couple years ago. Oh, this tool is so satisfying. Huh. Yeah, they're so easy to put on and so hard to take off. But I just used carriage bolts here instead of hucks. But the problem is I can't get behind there. So I'm gonna have to take this A-pillar cover off, which just snaps into place, but then I gotta unbolt this and it kind of snowballs in order to get at that, but that's gonna be the way it has to go, right? That's the only way I can get in there. And I need to take the visor off to be able to paint the front of the roof cap. Oh, hope you're learning from my mistake, folks. This is what's called a blind mount because the bolts are in behind. Whereas if you had the bolts or the screws coming through the front, that would be a typical mount, I guess. The blind mount's nicer because then you can't see it. Okay, that should do it. Oh. And there you go. One drop. Huh. Now that's gonna be a little bit of a pain. So it would appear that I actually used huck bolts to hold these brackets on there. And since I don't have a huck gun, I think I'm gonna leave them on there, but they're gonna kind of be in the way for painting. And speaking of being in the way, I guess I should probably get these windshield arms off of here and get the glass out as well. Well, yeah, I'll take the lights off and think about it. If you recall when I painted I put the new windshield glass in Snowman, the rubber didn't quite line up because of course you're only just gonna mask it as good as you can, and then when you get a new piece of new outer rubber ring, it may not line up and it may show some of the old paint underneath. But if I take the glass screens out now and this rubber ring off, how am I gonna keep paint and sanding dust from going into the cab of my nice finished interior? So again, the proper order probably would have been to tear the truck down, do all the body work, take the glass out, paint the thing, and who cares if paint gets inside, and then do the interior, and then new windshield glass, and then put on all the chrome. So third time's a charm. I'm actually doing it right with the Duke. I've got the glass out of it. I'm gonna paint the inside of the cab, the outside of the cab, and then I'll bolt it all on there. So by the third time, I do figure it out and get it right. Okay, so I guess next, I've got to get the lights off the roof there, and then I got a new puller to see if I can't get these windshield arms off. that stung to cut those wires, but there wasn't much else I could do. And actually one of them, the white wire in this one, pulled out. So I'm gonna have to drop the front headliner where the CB and the speakers are in order to get at that, but that's a problem for another day. And what I can't figure out to save my life is, so the cab is a little bit bigger than the Kenworth. Well, maybe it's about the same width, but obviously the bunk on the snowman is a lot narrower than this big bunk. So how the heck is the guy gonna reach it? Like, I mean, even if I put my knees here, just trying to imagine how I'm gonna paint. And I mean, I could maybe spray the first 6 inches or maybe the first foot of the bunk, but how the hell am I gonna reach all the way to the front from the back? I'm only gonna get to about the middle. See, that was, like I say, that was the benefit of that 36 inch bunk as opposed to this big wide 63. I'm gonna have to ask Ezra how he painted his. I mean, maybe he came at it from the sides, or I wonder if I could build some sort of platform on the gantry and then wheel it forward that goes over top of the bunk, and then I could stand there and paint, then get down, move it back, and then paint the rest of it. So anyway, problem for another day. I'll let my brain chew on that for a while. If anyone's got any ideas how to get to the center of a 63-inch bunk with a paint gun, let me know. So now what I want to do is try and get the windshield wiper arms off. Now, I've struggled with these something fierce on all my trucks. Couldn't get them off on Snowman. So if you saw that episode where I was putting the glass in behind, it was a real treat. And I couldn't get them off on the Duke. So we're gonna try this one now. One of the fans out there suggested to get a windshield arm puller. I ordered one off Amazon, and we'll see how that works. Now these things are on there something fierce because of course it's 45 years old, and it's been on there. And I'm not sure if it's two different metals, if it's aluminum and steel, because man, they sure get corroded. Okay, what's going on here? How's this work? Oh, there we go. Okay. Okay, try this. Okay, I think this may have worked, folks. And it won't seem to turn anymore. Oh, there it goes. Oh, well, it worked. So that's the ticket. You get one of these guys, and then you can get your windshield wiper arms out of the way. Man, that worked slick as snot. That came right off of there with no trouble. So that is definitely the tool that you need if you're gonna be restoring old trucks to get your windshield wiper arm off. So now I'm taking a look at the windshield here, and I think this is gonna have to come out just because there's no way for me to do a good job of cleaning up the rust there. And the cowl, I remember it was kind of leaking, so I just shot silicone in there, and I'm never gonna get this clean and smooth and flat with the windshield in place. So what I think I'll do is I'll pull the rubber out, pull the glass, pop the glass out, and then what I can do is use the glass as a template on cardboard, and then put the cardboard piece in there, and then maybe I'll duct tape it from the inside. I'm sure there's a way to make that work to keep dust and crap out of there. But then, like I say, at least I can get going at this cowl and clean this mess up, because this is pretty garbage. And yeah, I guess I'm gonna have to order a new one of these from Dirks. I don't know what the name of them is. It's just a rubber edge that goes along and seals along there. So you can get the kit from Dirks, and it's got the new rivets as well. So grind that off of there. Well, just break it off, I guess. And then we'll get a new one of those on order. Done. that's I think it's time I earned my treat. That was a bit of work getting those out of there. But they're out now. One of the challenges is that those arms or the mounts for the visor were kind of in the way and they were hitting the glass. So the glass had to slide out as opposed to just coming out forward. But they're out of there now. So I'll just need to, like I say, figure out some way, maybe heavy poly, that might work. And just tape it all around the inside. That might be an easier way than cardboard. Again, I'm just trying to keep the overspray and the crap out of my nice interior. Okay, well, glad that job's done. A lot of people were always asking, when are you gonna get your windshields replaced? Well, now they're gonna get replaced. But what I might do is I might call in, you know, Speedy Auto Glass or a professional to come and put that in again, because it's got to slide in at an angle, which is probably beyond my skill set. Okay, on to the next thing. The thing I might do next is try and pop out this little piece of glass as well, because again, this is going to be very obvious. If I try and mask it and I don't do a good enough job, well, I guess I'll see. I suppose I could mask it off. It's still going to be blue, but I kind of want to, because you can almost see the white underneath. Because they obviously didn't pop this out. There's the white paint there. So they didn't do a very good job masking it. So I figure if I pop this out, again, I'm gonna bring a professional in and hopefully I don't break it. Worst case, I'll get a new piece of glass made. But it's the same idea. It's got that little rubber ring that you just pull out like that. And that should relieve the pressure. I'll try and save this. Sweet! See, Sheriff? I didn't break it. Oh, look at that. Original colors. We got red, kind of a maroon or a brown, and then almost a gold tan. This is a three-tone truck with white. So it was white, bronze, kind of, so it went darker as it went up. This thing must have looked sharp back in the day. Okay, make sure I save this. Yeah, I'm happy with that. Now I can properly sand that down all the way to the edge. Okay, so next up I want to get rid of these stainless steel skirts on both the cab and the bunk. It's a bunch of little 7/16 bolts, which shouldn't be too hard to take off. But the reason I want to take them off is because I want to be able to sand right to the edge. And what I believe is going to happen is, as I'm sanding, I guarantee I'm going to catch this stainless steel and I'm going to scuff it up. So it's in pretty good shape now. Best thing to do is just take it off, get it out of there, and I don't even need to worry about masking it up or anything. So I'll get out the wrench and get going on that. Truck ugly in one short episode, and it's sure going back to the way it used to look when it was sitting out in the gravel before I had those skirts on there and when I was doing the roof cap.
You know, as the name implies, just keep kind of going one step at a time, and you know, hopefully little by little we'll get there.
Yeah, it's bringing back memories. So put a good dent in it today. I'm still gonna finish the other side. I'm going to clean up all my mess, try and put all these nice parts away somewhere safe where they don't get damaged. And then next week, yeah, I'm gonna hit it again. Try and take some more stuff off that I missed, and I'll probably start doing the sanding, start doing the body work. Yeah, it shouldn't take too long though, because again, I've learned how to do it with the snowman truck, and it doesn't need as much body work, so it should go pretty quick. and with any luck, she'll be shiny by summer. So with that, hope you enjoyed the episode. Thanks for following along. Please subscribe, hit the like comment down below, because when you hit the like or you comment, it actually, YouTube sends it out to more people and you can help old TwinSticks out. So I really appreciate that. And yeah, with that, gonna wrap it up there. And don't ever forget, if you got it, trucker brought it.